mode to another. This is how an actual JCL will look like. Double slash for each of the statements. No double slash when you're trying to pass some data or when you're trying to have some kind of in-stream data over here. And then comes your JCL closure of your in-stream. That means this marks that there are no more lines.
Okay.
Absolutely. There are no more lines which have an absence of double slash. This slash star tells that, okay, you're done and you're not going to pass anything into this area.
Oh, okay.
One job statement, one exit statement. You can have multiple exit statement. This shows there is a single exit statement though, and you have multiple DD statements. So as I said, exec PGM is equal to any program or utility you want to execute becomes your exec statement. So you will give a COBOL program name over here, or you will give IBM defined utilities over here. Now sort is a kind of IBM defined utility. So for this, for an example over here, this tells that PGM is equal to sort is a defined utility.
Okay, so in the place of sort, so we're going to give any kind of COBOL program name to right. exec statement is nothing but so that gonna be execute that COBOL program, right? So
absolutely. That's, okay. So this yeah. one, right? So if you see that, even this is the live example or the real time example. Why I'm saying is. Okay. An exec statement carry is divided into two parts. One is you can write your own program and you can execute them, okay. and you give the job program name over here. You okay. will either even run some utilities. When I say some utilities, this can be a sort utility. I'll tell you these are called tools. I'll tell you what are they. So sort is an IBM defined utility. Utility. That means the company has its own developed utility and you can run over here. You can run as a part of PGM equal to sort.
Yes. Okay.
You can run this JCL actually as is. If you copy this entire set of lines and if you paste it in your JCL and if you submit it, the JCL will run. Okay. That's what I'm saying. So you're not writing your own program over there. Already the program has been written and it's been defined. It is available to everyone who is using mainframe. So these are IBM for IBM defined utilities. Sort, there could be ice tool. There are many things where you are not writing, but it's a system defined tool.
System defined okay.
program basically. That's system defined programs. Okay. So this is an exec statement. You can have a program of your own, or you can even have a system defined programs,
yeah,
which are IBM defined. Yeah. Now, how they help you out, I'll cover it in another session also.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, now comes your the DD state. DD stands for data definition. So
yeah.
You can have multiple DD statements. They have their own meaning in the way they have been coded in a JCL. So if I have sort in as a DD statement, these names, right, Sai, these first after double slash, you're always giving some user defined names or system defined names. The way you have given a system defined program name or a user defined program name. Since sort is a system defined program name, it has its own system defined DD names.
Okay, so these system defined names are common for all the programs, or else so it depends upon the program we write or something else.
Right, I'll come right. So always remember that after double slash you're calling this as a name field. This is called operation field, and these are called operands.
Okay.
Name field means it's a job name, this is a skep name, and this is a DD name. You got my point? Since it's a job on the first line, you call it as a job name.
Job name.
Since it's on the exec line, this is called step name.
Okay.
I said that JCL is divided into skeleton is divided into three: job statement, step statement, and the DD statement. If you get back to the slides, right, you see that job name, step name, and DD
and
name.
The DD name. Yeah.
Okay, I'll share this slide with you, and it's not a very complex one. You will easily get on net as well. Okay.
Yeah.
So this is job name, this is step name, and the DD name. Now, for me to answer your question, I have to give you some description that, as I said, you can have system-defined utilities or you can have user-defined programs. System-defined programs are IBM-defined programs. So when IBM has developed the product or the tool, right, or this program, right, what you're seeing is a sort is an IBM-developed program. Any mainframe system in the world can run this JCL. Blindly.
Okay.
You don't need to change anything except you need to change this file name.
Okay.
Okay. So these DD names are universal for system defined programs.
Okay.
These DD names, sort in, sort out. For example, if you give your name or my name over here, the system will not understand these DD names. Only for the system defined program. For if you write your own program and if you give your own wish, this will run. But whenever you are trying to run a system defined program, you should have system defined DD names. Since we are on the DD line, you called it as a DD name. If you're on exec line, you call it as a step name. If you're on the job line, you call it a job name. So for your question, yes, you have to at any cost use only these names if you're running a system-defined program.
Okay.
But for instance, Sai has developed a COBOL program and he has written that program name as addition. The program actually adds two numbers, for instance, if we take an example. So you can have your own DD names.
Okay.
So you got my point, right?
Yeah, I got
you. I'll tell you, I'll relate how things will go on. Okay. So for now, just understand. Okay.
Yeah.
If you go into COBOL, right, the DD names are nothing but these, you call them as a physical DD name. Physical name where you actually give the file name. Okay. And in the COBOL program, you relate this, you have to read a file, right? You understand a program will read a file and write something.
Or
it will read a database and write something. On the same lines, you have logical DD names inside the COBOL program and you have the physical DD names inside the JCL.
Okay.
Okay. So I'll get into that description more, and in the sessions to come, you'll understand where these DD names have been used in your program. But for this session and for this training classroom, we will confine to our understanding that for any of your step name, which has a IBM defined program, you will have to use your IBM defined DD names.
Okay.
Now, these sorting signifies that it is a file which you are using or which you are supplying to the JCL, which has an IBM defined program name called sort. You know what do you mean by sort, right? It actually organizes the data.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Organizes. So sorting is a program or a utility that has been defined by IBM and it is supplied to anyone who uses mainframe. By default.
Okay.
It's there for everyone. So you give your file name to make your data sorted. You are not actually writing any program. You are just using this and you will make your file to be sorted. So these are system defined utilities or system defined programs. Now, DD parameter has DD data definition has many parameters tagged to it. So disp is nothing but a disposition. I'll describe you and explain you what all each of your statements has more parameters tagged to it, because you have many parameters which are not shown in the JCL. But just try to understand in a simple way that a simple JCL will look like this.
Okay. The give a job. The job name, the job name, the exec statement, and the DD statements. That the system statements. That's it. Perfect. So that's a simple JCL job. Yeah.
Okay. Perfect. Right. So, since you are using a system defined utility over here, these are IBM defined utilities, and you are defining with the IBM defined DD names.
DD names. Okay.
Okay. If, for example, if you give Ravi and Sai over here, right? Mm-hmm. The system, the mainframe will not understand what you are giving over here.
Yeah.
Right. Simple dude. If you are trying to insert a bike key into your car, it will not start, right?
It's not start. Yeah.
So it will not understand what you are trying to insert, or
yes.
It will not even take the key inside, because
yes.
The keyhole is prepared only to take the car key inside.
Particular key. Yeah.
Specifically, in the same lines, you have to key in only the DD names which are understandable or which are predefined by IBM to run IBM. This utility.
Okay, got it.
Okay. So it's a sort in means you are trying to sort an input file called IBM user.area.codes. Mm-hmm. It's an example. So we see a IBM file name over here. So in this place, you will give your own file which you want to sort. For instance, yeah. You have a file where you want to sort the data based upon the employee ID or based upon the department ID. So you will define that file which you want to sort. I'll tell you what are the sort criterions and everything in this line. I'll explain. I'll come to this line and I'll tell you what its significance. Now let's come on to the sort out DD name. Now sort out means you are sorting out this file. You gave an unsorted input file and you are actually getting a sorted output. Now what these guys did is, in this example, sort DD sys out is equal to star means you want to sort this file and you want to show or display it on the system itself. So whenever you see something called equal to star, you see a star over here, you see a star over here, right? They define in the way they have been coded. So sort out DD sys out equal to star, meaning I gave an unsorted file as an input. I am getting a sorted output on the system itself.
Okay.
For instance, if I give the same file name over here, right? Mm-hmm. You got my point, right? Sort in DD disposition share is it and comma, and I gave a file name.
If I copy
the entire lines, right? Sai, if I copy the entire line and if I paste it over here, my sorted input file becomes my sorted output file.
Sorted output file, yeah.
Right. But what they wanted to do is they wanted to show it on the system, on the system screen itself. That means you have an unsorted file being displayed on this system as sorted output. But when you open this file and see, right, the data is still unsorted.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because you have sorted the file and you made it to show on the system, but you didn't give the same file as sort out DD statement.
Okay.
So a lesson over here is, when I give something over here as an input, I can display it on the system or I can write it to a file as well. So this is an input statement. This is an output statement. It's a basic input and output.
Output statement. Okay.
I'm supplying something and I'm retrieving something. So I gave a file which is an unsorted file, and I'm trying to get the sorted output.
Yeah.
Either you can show it on the system screen on their itself. That means your data is still unsorted site. Try to remember what I'm trying to say carefully. You gave, because you are showing it in the system. You are not giving the file to be sorted out.
Yeah.
Right? So if I copy from this line to this line entirely, and if I paste it over here,
the same unsorted, the file that we have given as an input, that comes as an output actually. So if we just paste the same line, the sort in the sort out, that's right.
Right, but what would be the difference over here?
Just it comes in a sorted manner.
Absolutely. You got the point then. Good.
Yeah.
I hope I'm very clear.
Yeah.
I hope I'm not going too speedy. Just stop me, because these are very basics. And if you understand this, your real-time life will be very easy. Okay.
Yeah.
So when you're trying to supply something as an input, you can either supply, you can show it on the system, or you can actually manipulate your file when you supply it over here.
Okay.
Now I can have a sysout. So these are all DD statements, right? Remember, you had one job statement, you have one exec statement, you had multiple DD statements. As I said, you can have more than one exec statement.
Yeah.
And you can have more than one DD statement as well. So on those lines, you had a DD statement which signifies your input. You had another DD statement which signifies that you are showing the sorted output on the system, because you coded it as sysout equal to star. If you have given the DSN, if I have copied the same thing and pasted it over here, my sorted input now becomes my sorted output. Okay. Now sysout DD sysout equal to star. This tells the mainframe system that whatever messages or whatever the execution happened because of this utility, show me out on the screen. That means, for example, if my job failed, now I want to see the reasons, right, why it failed. If my job went fine, now I want to see the reasons why the job went fine as well. So basically, the results are, this is the DD statement which tells the system, with tells the operating system that, okay, show me the
what's the result is, whether it is fine or whether it is an error.
Absolutely. So that shows the result of it on the system. So if I remove this statement, right, I cannot see the messages. The job will run fine, or even it fail, I'll not see all those messages, which will help me to debug. You understand debug, what you mean by debug, right? You're trying to fix it, basically.
Yes.
So that's where it's debug. So now, coming back to another DD statement, this is called a sysin DD star. Sysin is again a system defined keyword by IBM for this sort utility. All these DD names are mandatory, and all these DD names have to be used as they have been shown on this slide. You cannot change the DD names. They are helping you out to sort the data for your file, and all these statements are mandatory. The only thing which you can change is you can give any step name over here. That's not a problem.
Okay.
But once you give the step name, and upon after that, you have to follow some defined rules that the DD name has to be accordingly to what sort is expecting, or IBM, the utility is expecting to run this job.
So
these are the default DD names, I can say. The ones which have to be used as they have been coded. Now, as I said, once you make this double slash to be absent, you have something called an in-streamed data. What do you mean by in-stream data? You supply some data over here, or you supply some statements over here, instructing the program what's to be done. That means in this job, right? Don't get worried, Sai. Once we get into the real mode of it, right, you'll understand it.
Okay.
So just understand the basics of it. What this area means, what this set of DD statements mean, what this exec statement mean, what this job mean.
Okay.
So once the basics are strong, right, I think you make mistakes and you learn out of mistakes. So each time you make a mistake, there's a learning coming out of it.
Yeah.
So chill, that should not be a big deal though. Okay. Now, this statement is a systemd start statement. You give, there are two ways of it, Sai. All, either you have DD and you have a DSN over here. You see how the DD statement is changing its face. What it did is, it gave a DD statement and it took a DSN as a file. DSN means dataset name.
Yeah, dataset name, yeah.
I'll explain more. There are a lot of parameters on this DD statement. For now, just understand this. It's a data definition. Yep. And all these data definition statements define something about some data.
Okay.
Sysout equal to star. I said you can use a file name as well. DD, DSN equal to, you can give the same file name, or you can give a new file name.
Mm-hmm.
When you give a new file name, the disposition changes, which I'll explain more. Now, coming back to this area, so Sai, segment your understanding, okay? Break down your understanding that my jobs, my JCL is always broken into three pieces. One is the job statement, the other one is the exec statement, the other one is the DD statement. All the time, your job will have these mandatory statements.
Okay, yeah.
Now, coming on to the systemd star, in this place, you can even give a DSN. That means you can give a file name and you can put the state, put these statements into the file name. Okay, I'll tell you how it goes. So if I, whenever I'm trying to give it in within the same scope of the JCL, that means in the same JCL, I'll give it as a star. And I'll give as sort fields equal sort fields. It's an English-like statement which you will understand that what you're trying to do. You understood, right? I am sorting my file from the first position to the third position, which are character in nature, and I'm trying to sort them in ascending order.
Ascending order. Oh, okay.
Trust me, mainframe, actually, ever since mainframe got its existence, it got its fame because it is simple to learn in a way, and it is English like language overall.
Okay.
That's COBOL has got its familiarity because of that. Even if you get to see the JCL also, right? You yourself could say that, okay, sort fields means you can understand that. You're trying to sort the fields. The only thing is you need to understand the syntactical nature of what they do. That means from the first position in the file to the third position of the input file. So we're trying to sort the first three fields of this file. You get my point?
Yes.
So in this file, if I'm trying to sort my employee ID, which is of 3 bytes, for example, 123 is my employee ID. Okay. And it is sitting on the first position to the third position of the file.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'll show you. I'll open I'll show you a file and how the data ordinance will get known. Hey, Vasu, can you go on mute? Is Vasu there?
No.
You're getting a lot of noise.
Oh, I think it's from my side, my roommates. Just a second.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, sorry.
Never mind. Yeah. So sort fields means you're trying to sort the fields which start from 1 and which end at 3. That means it's a 3-byte data which you're trying to sort inside this file in the ascending manner, which is character in nature. Okay. I hope you at least understood the skeleton of the JCL and what we are trying to do. So the gist of this slide is there are either user-defined programs which are user rights, or there are IBM-defined programs which has IBM already has its own the system. For example, if you have the mainframe access at your office and if you go and copy paste this JCL, right? This will run. Except you need to change the job ID. Right. It changes from system to system and from company to company. You have some specifications. Copy paste this job ID and you give the file name, this JCL will run.
Okay.
Now, I hope you understood, right? Job statement, exit statement, and the DD statement.